Let's turn around and tell each other good morning and shake hands and...
Morning, everybody.
Good morning.
And Jacob's going to open us with prayer.
Almighty Father, Lord, we come into your house today to learn your teaching, your lesson, so we may go out and teach it to others. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
And if you're able, please stand for our song of praise. It'll be hymn number 144, verses 1 through 3. This is my Father's world.
Nature sings and round.
place your hands on us and show us the best way to use these to carry out your work on this earth and to spread your word as we know that you would have us to do. We ask this in your name. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Does anybody have any joys they'd like to share?
Oh, I do. John had a birthday yesterday.
Yes.
Oh, right. Happy birthday, John.
Thank you. His request, y'all know my name, his request was Splitwood. So we all have fun names.
Well, let's sing happy birthday. Doesn't get any better than that, does it?
That's right.
Any other joys?
I think it's a joy just to be here.
I agree. Anybody have any prayer requests or concerns?
Is that Tommy's wife, Sandra?
It's Tommy's wife.
I would like to correct something that I said last week because I didn't know any better. I said that they had caught Jennifer's breast cancer soon enough that everything looked okay. She had an MRI this week, and it's not going to be okay. They are going to do some genetic testing on Monday to make sure about the girls to see if they're going to be concerned. She is probably looking at a mastectomy now, and we don't know she will see her oncologist on the 3rd, and she has some other meeting on the 1st, but I would just ask to continue her in prayer. She called me yesterday evening, and she had been crying, and I said, you know, I'm just being funny. I said, you've reached my phone, call me back. And she said, I didn't hear a beat, and I said, well, I'll do it. And she said, well, I don't want to leave a crying message. She said, you know, everybody thinks that I'm so strong and I'm trying to be strong. She said, but I'm really not. And, you know, I told her it's okay. You need to cry, you call me. And you know, that's what we'll do. So she's trying to be strong, but, you know, every once in a while the human side comes out and you just can't take it anymore. So I would ask you to lift her up in prayer.
What's her name again, Kay?
Jennifer Surratt.
back up a minute. It's a joy and a prayer concern. Thank you again for what you did for my oldest son, Bray. He'd been gone the past 2 weeks with his race team, Max Flinders, a young man that's 28 that rides for him. And they got home on Tuesday after being from Texas to Atlanta for Moto America. And Bray's team is the only team that's called the Privateer. Everybody else is, you know, factory, Indian factory, Harley Davidson and all this. He's always been the little underdog. Well, Max fell in the race before, and being the young 28-year-old, he got back on that bagger that ones of you the pad motorcycles know was 600 and some pounds. He came in third behind two Indians. But where the glory in all this is, he had fractured his hip, continued to race, and on my son's Moto America Facebook post, people were saying, great job, Max, M3, Brandon White. And my son said, give God the glory, because we wouldn't be here without God.
Amen.
So if we can continue for Bray and Max, they'll be back in Wisconsin the end of May. And so he's taking it easy. The head of his, or the socket is what's got a hairline fracture. And he's just a good kid. I say kid at 28, but if Xander came up to him and said, hey, can I get on that motorcycle? He's going to say, go right ahead, young man. Let me help you up there. Do you want a picture too?
Any other prayer requests? What's his name? One more time. What was it? Nick Parker?
There's also a young man that I know him, but he came out of service a couple of years ago. He's got a son that's, I think, 14, and then he's got three sons that are like 4, 3, and 2. He just signed up to go back to Kuwait for a year, and they asked to put him on the prayer list.
What was his name again?
Justin Sharp.
Any other prayer requests?
I had a phone call yesterday, said, I think Nevaeh forgot us.
Okay. Any other requests?
For all those who may be traveling, that they have safe journeys.
Any other requests? request?
Remember Ricky and Brenda, they're both having medical issues.
Any other requests? At this time, let's go to the Lord in silent prayer. Almighty Lord, we thank you for another day. We thank you for having an opportunity to be in your house to worship you. We thank you for your forgiveness and your plan of salvation. Lord, it's with love that we lift up everyone that's on the prayer request, but we especially want to lift up the family of Diane Robinson, as they travel down the road of bereavement. And Jennifer, as her cancer seems to be worse than originally thought. We ask that you intervene and guide the doctor's hands and that your will be done. Lord, we pray for your people, the Jews that are being demonstrated against and treated so brutally that people realize that you're chosen people and that we all start standing up for them and helping them. Lord, we ask that you heal Max, that he takes it easy and doesn't have any permanent damage. And Lord, we lift up Nick Parker to you as he's in the hospital with a hemorrhage on his brain, that you guide the doctor's hands and that he is healed, but your will be done. Lord, we ask that you protect Justin Sharp as he's being deployed, that he can come back home to his family and be with his family to comfort, so that they can draw strength from you and confidence that he'll be fine. Lord, we ask that you be with Nevaeh, as this is her first time of being so far away, and with her wrestling, that things go well. We ask that you be with all the travelers. And Lord, we ask that you be with our church, that we can spread your word to more people in the community, and that our church starts to grow so that we can do more for you. For you in your name. Lord, we also ask that you be with Ricky and Brenda as they face some medical problems, that you guide the doctor's decision and that everything comes out well. Lord, we also ask that you continue to be with Bray and he continues to get better as time goes on. And what a joy it was to see him give you credit for so much. Lord, it's with love that we lift up a prayer that was given to us as a model of how to pray to you. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. And I'm going to turn everything over to the choir.
We also need to remember Tim as he fell and broke his kneecap.
Yeah.
I think that's right. So we need to remember him. Didn't mean to leave y'all to it.
That's okay. I always figured God knew anyway. Our scripture today comes from Genesis chapter 1, verse 1. Verse 1. In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. This is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Today, we're going to continue on the Rooted series that we started last week. We're going to talk about the attributes of God. Now, I want you to understand this is going to be a whirlwind sermon because there's so much of God that I couldn't cover it in a month up here. As we look at the fundamentals of our faith, we're going to see that God, see what God is like. Last week, we talked about the Bible as the foundation of Christianity. Today, we're going to talk about our God and what He is like. And this is going, there's no way that we can describe our God in one sermon, as I told you before. Or actually, in one lifetime, we wouldn't have the time. God is so much more than we can ever imagine, much less accurately describe. But we're going to look at a few attributes of God. Let me ask you a question before we go any farther. If you had a 69 Corvette, red convertible, you might would refer to it as, well, that's my 69. That's my Chevy. Oh, that's my red Corvette. Oh, that's my convertible. That's my antique car. Well, that's my old vet. Those are all attributes to that car. So everything we talk about with God today is an attribute to what He's able to do, what He is, what He means to our faith. He's fully and completely everything all the time. He doesn't sometime love you or me, but every day, every moment, God loves us. He never, never, ever stops loving us. He's not sometimes holy. He's permanently holy. He's always 100% of all the things that we just talked about. God exists. I just read that in Genesis chapter 1. And I'm going to kind of give you fair warning. I'm going to have a lot of reference scriptures. And I'm going to give them to you if you want to write them down. If I go through each reference scripture, we're going to be here at about 2 o'clock. Okay? Not that I mind being here that far. The Bible presents God as the Creator without any proof of His existence or actions. According to Romans chapter 1, verses 19 and 20, every person has an inner sense that God exists. We know from the moment we're born, there's a God. We know He's out there somewhere. We automatically long for His loving, His forgiveness, His understanding. From the moment of birth, all of creation shows us the existence of God. Everything. The leaves, the grass, the tiny little buds of leaves that are just starting, the animals, us. Human beings are created in God's image. And they give the greatest evidence of God and His character. Let's think about it. You know, we hear, there's always a lot of discussion, evolution versus creation. Look what we look at like today. We look the same way. Adam and Eve must have been the most perfect beings ever on earth because they were created in God's creation. God's beautiful. God's love. God is everywhere. Can you imagine what Adam and Eve looked like? Evidence of God's existence is found both in the Bible and in our natural world. Have you ever sat and watched a squirrel play? How they do? They're almost like cat kittens. Or a dog, how they treat a litter of puppies. Or cats, how they take care of a litter of kittens. That's given by God. That's given for our enjoyment, to show that He's here, that He's alive. He's not dead. God is independent. And you can reference that in Acts chapter 17, verses 24 through 25. God doesn't actually need us or anything else in creation for anything. God has always been perfectly and completely happy and fulfilled in His personal existence. God didn't need to make us. God didn't need to give us free will. But He did, because He wants people to acknowledge Him on their own. He wants people to come to Him without being forced. Zephaniah 3:17 references He chose to give us value and significance. He allows us to be important to Him. How important are we? Was so important that He gave His only Son. How much love is that? How much more does He need to show that He loves us? God is unchangeable. You can find that in Malachi chapter 3, verse 6. God is unchangeable in His being, attributes, purposes, and promises. He's totally trustworthy in what He has said. You can trust God to keep every word that's in this Bible. You can trust God with everything that you're carrying in your life. He'll not let you down. God is incapable of lying or telling a lie. God is eternal. God has no beginning or end. He has always existed. God is unlimited by time. Time's different for God. You have to keep in mind, not only did He create the earth, but He created time. And uses it, and He wants us to use it for His purpose. God has all the time there is. God is omnipresent. Psalms 137, verses 7 through 10. God is unlimited by space. God is present in every part, every inch, every millimeter of space. There's nowhere you can go that God's not there. Think about that. Nowhere that you can go. God is spirit. John 4, verse 24. God exists in such a way that his being is not made of any matter. This is matter. This is matter. God is invisible. God can walk through walls. God can sit and see exactly what's going on. God knows what you're thinking as you're thinking it. He knows what you feel in your heart as you feel it. He's always present. At certain times, God has chosen to appear to people. John 14, verse 9, references God has made himself visible in Jesus Christ. And he did. For a little over 33 years, God walked in Jesus on this earth. Let you think about that just a second. Can you imagine talking to Jesus? Can you imagine what it would be like to sit down and break bread with Jesus, to come to the realization that that's actually God too, and the Holy Spirit? God is omniscient. God at all times is fully aware of everything. Nothing surprises him or is ever hidden from him. God has known all things that will happen and all things that he would do. He knew what Adam and Eve was going to do, that they would eat from the tree of knowledge. He knew that where they were at when he was trying to find them. He was just giving them a chance to do the right thing. He knows what we're going to do for every situation that we're going to face. God is wise. He always chooses the best possible goals and the best possible means to meet those goals. The problem is, he chooses the way for us to travel, and then we don't follow his path, and we get ourselves into trouble. God is truthful. Jeremiah chapter 10, verse 10. All his knowledge and all his words are both true and the standard of truth. Once he says something, we can count on him doing it. We can count on him being forever faithful to his promises. God promised us that if we accepted Jesus as our Lord and personal Savior, we would have a place in heaven. You will have a place in heaven. God is good. You can reference that in Luke 18, verse 19. All he is and does is good and worthy of approval. God is the final standard of good. All the goodness we seek is ultimately found in God himself. God is holy. God is separate from sin and devoted to seeking his own honor. He seeks his own honor because he can't sin. He's perfect. But God is a jealous God. Exodus chapter 20, verse 5. God continually seeks to protect his honor. He desires that worship be given only to him and not to anything or anyone else. It's not wrong for God to continually seek his own honor because only he deserves it. God is the only God. And yes, he has different names depending on where you're from, just like Simon says. But there's only one God. God wields what he wields. And you can reference that in Ephesians chapter 1, verse 11. God's will is the ultimate reason for everything that happens. God's will is how he chooses to do what he does and doesn't do. God's not to be blamed for or thought responsible for sin or evil things. That's not him. That's Satan. The relationship between his will and evil is not something he's chosen to reveal to us. But I can't wait to sit down and ask him when I get there. God has freedom. Nothing can hinder God from doing his will. Not you, not me, not anybody. He is not constrained by anything outside of himself. He is completely free to do whatever he wants to do. God is all powerful. God is able to forgive people because Christ died to take God's punishment of sin on himself. God is love. God eternally gives of himself for the good of others. The ultimate expression of God's love is seen in the giving of Jesus Christ. Do you think God enjoys giving his son up for us? No. God couldn't even watch Jesus died, but he gave him for us so we can have a way to come and live with him. Amen. If you're able, please stand. Our hymn will be on page 707. Verses 1 through 3, Hymn of Promise.
Amen.
As you go home today, remember, God is everywhere. He's always there for you. He's always waiting for you to ask him for help. Trust in him and believe in him. Amen. Jason, want to close the session?
Let's go to the Lord in prayer, please. Dear gracious Heavenly Father, Lord, as we leave this place, let us remember that you are everywhere. You created everything. You created every being, every animal, every season, every day. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.